t-shirt. It costs £10. But how much is it costing the environment?
Everybody is waking up to the fact that the fashion industry has a problem it needs to fix.
We need to act now. This is it.
Hauls, lookbooks, what's in your bag? One thing's for sure, we're obsessed with new clothes. The fashion industry is enormous. Profits, jobs, a sense of identity, new clothes do a lot for us. We buy more clothes than any other European country, and we throw away a million tons of them every year. The main culprit for this throwaway culture is the fast fashion industry, the high turnover of cheap clothes to keep up with constantly changing trends.
There aren't just four seasons anymore, there's 52 micro seasons. So is fast fashion out of control? Well, back to our t-shirt.
This one is 100% cotton. In the first place, cotton production uses a lot of water, 1 kilogram of it. Roughly 4 of these t-shirts can take as much as 10,000 to 20,000 litres of water to produce. Then whatever's been picked has to be made into cotton fibre. That's 8% of the t-shirt's carbon footprint. Then spinning to make yarn and making fabric takes a huge amount of energy, 20% of the t-shirt's CO2 potential. Then things like sizing, printing, and dyeing are a huge contributor to its carbon footprint, 50% of it, and have the potential to pollute the world's rivers. 4% of its emissions are created transporting the t-shirt from production to the shop floor. Then you might drive your car to buy it or order it online to get it delivered straight to your door. That's 15% of its footprint. You'll wash, iron, and dry it throughout its use, 3% of its total emission. And then when you're fed up with it, you might just throw it in the bin. In total, this t-shirt has the potential to cause 2.4 kilograms of CO2. If we extract that out to all the t-shirts and other stuff being produced and bought every year, clothes are contributing around 1.2 billion tons of CO2 emissions. That's more than international flights and maritime shipping combined.
We're going to look into how big fashion brands are trying to reduce their environmental impact. Some people have called it greenwashing. But first, we're going to meet Venetia, who's a slow fashion activist.
This shirt I found in a charity shop for a couple of pounds, same as this one. This shirt dress I've had for years and I absolutely love.
What is slow fashion?
Slow fashion is the antithesis of fast fashion. To me, it is making the most of all the clothes that are already in existence, starting with our own wardrobes and feeling comfortable to wear clothes time and time again.
Isn't slow fashion not something that everyone can afford to do?
I am privileged to be able to think about what the clothes that I wear, and I'm also privileged to have the money to be able to afford to shop in charity shops and vintage shops out of choice rather than necessity. I have to be aware of my privilege here. However, there are a lot of people who have the same privilege as me who aren't necessarily thinking about the clothes that they're wearing and could be making more conscious and more ethical decisions. I don't think this is about boycotting fashion, because fashion's such a good way to express ourselves. But we are in a climate breakdown. We are in a state of emergency. The time is now. We need to act now.
So if Venetia's right and the time is now, what can the fashion industry do to limit their impact on the environment?
There are three big initiatives that UK fashion brands can sign up to. The first is SCAP, the Sustainable Clothing Action Plan, and that looks at water, carbon and waste and ways to reduce it. The Microfiber Consortium, or TMC, looks to reduce the amount of microfibers we have in our oceans and the environment. And the Ethical Trading Initiative, or ETI, which promotes workers' rights all around the world. But how many of our big fashion brands are actually signed up to any of this?
We looked at the 20 most popular fashion and clothing brands in the UK, and only 2 out of the 20, 1% of the UK's most popular brands, are signed up to all three. And who are the two? Next and Primark.
So just because shops are cheap, does that mean they're the worst for the planet?
Primark, for instance, say they can justify their low prices for the consumer by not spending big money on things like billboard or TV advertising. And what about designer brands? Burberry made headlines in 2018 when they admitted they burned £28 million worth of excess stock. They say they've now put a stop to that. we met up with designer Patrick Grant in his Savile Row Tailors to see whether the luxury end of the market might be damaging the planet just as much as the fast fashion brands.
There are many so-called luxury brands that are really all about mass consumption. I mean, is a brand really luxury if there's one in every single airport in the world and, you know, on every high street in every major city? They are as guilty of greedy malpractice as I think a lot of other people at the lower end of the spectrum are. I mean, they're using better materials, they're using more ethical labour, their clothes will last a lot longer, but certain things that they are doing are all about aggressive consumption. And things like burning, you know, burning excess stock, we know is clearly, you know, ethically, you know, dubious at best. I mean, it's frankly, it's just wrong.
The fact remains that the entire fashion industry, including both high street and designer brands, is having a huge impact on the world around us and is growing at completely unsustainable rates. Of course, we're talking mostly about environmental costs in this video, but there's also concern about the people making our clothes. There's been a history of forced labour in Uzbekistan, where a huge amount of cotton is picked. Back in 2013, a clothes factory in Bangladesh collapsed, killing more than 1,000 people. And in Britain, an investigation in 2017 found that workers in some of Leicester's factories were being paid as little as £3 an hour. When it comes to the environment, some companies are starting to make a change. Here at this warehouse, you've got the likes of Very and ASOS sending their stock that doesn't sell here to be recycled. But a committee of MPs who wrote a huge report into fast fashion say it's still not enough.
The Environmental Audit Committee made loads of different suggestions in here. One of them was having a ban on the industry putting any unused clothes into landfill. And another one is putting a tax on every single item of about a penny to make sure that some of the money goes into running recycling centres like this one.
But the government said no to those suggestions. They say their plans already include making sure the textile and fashion industry is fully responsible for the costs of clothes that are thrown away, as well as encouraging greater reuse and recycling. But the organisation that runs the SCAP scheme we mentioned earlier, the Sustainable Clothing Action Plan, has lost 80% of its government funding since 2010.
And some say that without government forcing these big fashion companies to be more environmentally friendly, little is going to change.